Today we commemorate the synopsis of the holy archangels, Michael, Gabriel, Raphael, and of all the heavenly hosts. We have eight archangels up in the dome, and usually on the iconostasis there are two archangels, Michael and Gabriel. We know about the archangels and the angels from Scripture, although it's not all very clear and delineated. Our deacon today, Richard, read the gospel, the epistle from St. Paul to the Hebrews, speaking of angels. And we know a certain amount about them. St. Paul tells us that there are nine ranks of angels. And we know something about some of them, but not all of them. The highest ranks are the cherubim and the seraphim. But then there are also dominions, thrones, virtues, principalities, archangels and angels. So we know about the two, the cherubim, the cherubim and the seraphim. And as a matter of fact, these fans that we use in processions are called the seraphim, because we know that the seraphim have six wings, and it says with two they cover their faces, with two they fly, with two they cover their bodies, and it has six wings. And here's the Lord, and all around them are the cherubim and angels. And these fans, when you have the full retinue of people who are supposed to be in a liturgy with bishop and priest and deacons and subdeacons, every time we come out with communion, these fans are supposed to be held over the communion cup by the subdeacons. When we read the gospel, these fans are supposed to be held over the gospel, showing that the angels, the cherubim and the seraphim, are there. They're surrounding God, that God is present, and these angels are there. We know that the cherubim and the seraphim stand around the altar of God. And when we sing the, when we say, stop singing the triumphant hymn, when I bang on the discos, it's, we begin to sing, holy, 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 Lord God of Sabaoth. Isaiah the prophet tells us that this is what the archangel, what the seraphim and the cherubim sing to the Lord as they're around him at his throne. That's their function, to be around the Lord. The others, I don't know. We don't know. There's really no developed theology of angels. And the church did that specifically because there were people who were worshiping the angels. And even today, this New Age philosophy has much to do with angelology, with angels. The church doesn't worship angels. The angels are only agents of God. They're used by God. It's God that we worship, but the angels have a very, very specific function. Those two, as I mentioned, the cherubim and the seraphim, are around the throne of God. The others I can't tell you because Scripture doesn't tell us, but it does tell us about the archangels and the angels. And the archangels are called strategos, the generals. That's the word that strategy comes from. They're the strategists. That the strategy comes from the strategists who are the leaders of the heavenly host. And it says in the prayer that there are thousands of archangels and tens of thousands, hosts of angels. And angel means messenger. The angels are bodiless powers. And the prayer says that when man was created just a little lower than the angels. But when man goes up into the kingdom of heaven, he becomes higher than the angels. Just as we say about the Theotokos, she's more honorable than the cherubim and more glorious than the seraphim. So it's a very thought out process. But the angels are missionaries, they're the messengers of God. And they come to us. Now they can't take out a body. One of my favorite movies, as you know, was The Bishop's Wife. The bishop, of course, not Orthodox. It was David Niven, he was an Episcopalian bishop. Loretta Young was his wife. And the Lord sent him an angel. And who do you think that angel was?
Cary Grant.
Cary Grant. Beautiful picture. He took on a body temporarily because angels don't have bodies. And when he went back, they all forgot that he was there. But the Lord sent us angels. We never know in what sense or what guise they come to us, in our neighbor, in our friends, in our stranger. He sent us angels to help us because they are God's agents. And everyone who is baptized receives a guardian angel. During the liturgy, we pray for a faithful guide, an angel to be with us. There have to be millions of angels because every nation also is given an angel. I hope our angels watch you over the United States.
He is
and always shall be. The angels are those who do God's work. We can't see them with our eyes. Some people can. Some people can see them, and we know that the angels come down to us from heaven during every liturgy. I haven't been able to see them either. But there are those with spiritual eyes who can see them, can feel them. Many times, children say that they have conversations with the angels. And I believe, because of their innocence, that they can see them. Because it takes an innocent heart. The Lord said you have to become like little children in order to enter into the kingdom of heaven. But we should know that there's someone watching over us, always. How do we say God is everywhere present? Through his angels. Because he's given them the commission to watch over us, to protect us, to keep us safe. And in the Orthodox prayer books, there's a prayer to your guardian angel as well, to be with you, to watch over you, to protect you. It's a very special day that we have, that we commemorate the angels. They have to know that they are surrounding the throne of God at all times, and that they're also in the world doing God's work for us. His messengers. When Mary was chosen to be the mother of the Messiah, he sent the archangel Gabriel. And Gabriel was the messenger many times before her death, was sent to Joseph to convince him that Mary was expecting a child through the Holy Spirit. That was a very special mission, and that's why we know their names, because they were given in Scripture. Michael is the strategos, the chief of the heavenly host. But he wasn't originally the original chief archangel. You know who that was?
Yeah,
Lucifer. But because he wanted to be equal to God, he thought he could be, he fell, as Isaiah tells us, he fell from the heavens to earth. And he took many angels with him. And those angels also exist. Those angels that wish us harm. His followers. But God is stronger. God is stronger. This is not a battle of one God against another, against the God of good, against the God of evil. The devil has no comparison to God. God is the supreme power. And he will be defeated. He has been chained, and he will be defeated completely when the Lord comes back the second time with his angels. And we believe that when we go to the other kingdom, we are escorted by our angels, guardian angel, and other angels who come and take our souls. When the Holy Mother of God was taken up bodily into heaven, it was the angels that came and took her together with the Lord. So there's a whole theology of angels, but as I said, we don't emphasize emphasize the angels because many people were led to worship the angels, and that's not what we're here for. We're here to worship God. The angels are only His agents and His ministers. But they are a beautiful addition to our Christian faith. Knowing, can you imagine that this church is full with angels? It's full of angels, even though you don't see them. And how many angels can you fit in here? Hundreds of thousands, because they have no body. I love to tell the story about this priest in Russia, who was an older man. It was during the communist era, and his church was in a neighborhood where he had to pass a farmer who was an atheist. And the farmer would be sure to be at his fence whenever the priest passed. And he knew that when he was going to church or when there was a church service, he would be out there and say to him, "Ah, priest, who do you think is going to be in church today? Nobody. You're going to be there with yourself and a couple of old ladies." And he would dread going by there, but he had no choice. Well, one day was the holiday, the day of the archangels, and he's going to church, and there again is the farmer, telling him nobody's going to be in church. But when he got to church, there was a beautiful choir singing, a beautiful choir. He's looking, where did that choir come from? The church was filled with voices. He said, "In peace let us pray to the Lord," and it boomed out, "Lord have